Good day all. My name is Ashray and I'm part of the Identity Advanced Cloud Engineering team within Microsoft. This video here is a quick demonstration showing how an administrator can investigate their end users getting blocked unexpectedly by conditional access policies. This will help the admin understand which CA policy blocked the user and what are the conditions that led to the block. Let's start with a scenario where an end user Bob is trying to access Azure portal. Bob tries to access the Azure portal through portal.azure.com and finds out that his sign-in has been blocked. Every sign-in session has its own correlation ID, which can be used to uniquely identify the event. Hence, as an admin, you'd need the correlation ID and timestamp pair to investigate this issue. You can find this information from the error by clicking on the More Details hyperlink or by clicking on the Ellipsis button here at the bottom right corner of the page. Alternatively, further sign-in events can be flagged for review by enabling this option here. Once you have the correlation ID along with the username, you can navigate to the Diagnose and Solve Problems section here in the portal and click on the Troubleshoot button under the Signin Diagnostics option. This section will contain two tabs, one that showed flagged sign-in events and the other to investigate any other sign-in event. If the end user enabled flagging and reproduced their issue, the sign-in should be visible here in this section. If not, you can navigate to the All Sign-in Events and add some of the details that will help in loading the sign-in event. Here, we have added the username, the correlation ID, and timestamp from the data collected earlier. Once the data loads, select the event for it to run the diagnostics on. From the diagnostic results, you can see the summary of the sign-in. Since the block was unexpected, let's review the details to see what happened. Here, we can see that a policy named C01 blocked some users was the policy that was involved in the sign-in event. This tells us that Bob was one of the users in the configured user condition and that the username which was entered, denoted by the client submitted column, was Bob as well. Also, we can see that Bob is accessing Azure portal, which is part of the all apps condition that has been configured in the CA policy. These are the conditions which block the user through the CA policy. If this block was intended, then you can educate the user based on your internal policies. If not, you can make the necessary changes to the CA policy based on your requirements. If this did not help, you can navigate to the sign-in logs and filter the logs with the correlation ID and timestamp pair that was collected before to investigate further. Once you have selected the sign-in event, you can navigate to the conditional access section and check which policies don't apply and which policies have applied and have resulted in failures. Clicking on the context menu will show details that can help us understand this better. Here, you can see that the user condition and the application condition matched and the access control was to block the sign-in, which happened. Similarly, there could be scenarios where other conditions could match, like location condition, which you can see is a matched condition here, or device platform, or some other conditions which can also result in the sign-in event being blocked. As mentioned earlier, you can evaluate if this block was intended, and if not, make the necessary changes to the CA policies as per your internal requirements. I hope this helps you in better investigating your sign-in events. Thanks for watching.